Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On April 20th, Expedition 5152 flight engineer Jack Fischer of NASA and Soyuz commander Fyodor Yurchikhin of the Russian space agency Roscosmos launched to the International Space Station aboard a Soyuz spacecraft from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. About 6 hours later, the pair arrived at the orbital outpost and were greeted by station commander Peggy Whitson of NASA and other members of the crew. Fischer and Yurchikhin will spend 4.5 months conducting research aboard the station. Orbital ATK's Cygnus cargo spacecraft launched to the station atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket April 18th from the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. The Cygnus, named the SS John Glenn in honor of the late NASA astronaut and U.S. Senator from Ohio, is delivering more than 7,600 pounds of supplies and scientific experiments for the station crew. Following its arrival on April 22nd, the Cygnus is scheduled to spend the next 3 months at the station. Three extraordinary planet hunters have been named to Time magazine's annual list of the 100 most influential people in the world. Natalie Battaglia is a project scientist with NASA's Kepler mission. Kepler discovered the first Earth-sized planets beyond our solar system. She's joined on the list by Guillaume Anglada Escudé of the Queen Mary University of London, who discovered an Earth-sized planet orbiting Proxima Centauri in 2016, and Michael Gion of the University of Liège in Belgium, who recently announced the discovery of the first known system of 7 Earth-sized planets around a single star. The discovery was made using NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope and ground-based observatories. As NASA's Dawn spacecraft continues exploring the dwarf planet Ceres, there is growing evidence that Ceres has a significant amount of water ice. A new study in the journal Nature Geoscience adds to this picture, showing how ice may have shaped the variety of landslides seen on Ceres today. Research shows that Ceres is covered in landslides like those we experience on Earth, and furthers the case that the dwarf planet has a lot of water ice involved in its structure. NASA's senior Mars rover Opportunity is leaving Cape Tribulation, a crater rim segment it has explored since late 2014. Opportunity is headed southbound for the fluid-carved Perseverance Valley on the Cape Byron segment of the crater rim. The rover team plans observations in the valley in an effort to determine the type of fluid activity that carved out the valley billions of years ago – water, wind, or flowing debris lubricated by water. NASA's Earth Day celebrations this year include live and online public activities. The April 20th Earth Day in the nation's capital event at Washington's Union Station featured NASA hands-on activities and presentations, images of Earth on NASA's hyperwall, agency officials discussing the benefits of observing our home planet from the vantage point of space, and autographs from former astronaut Scott Altman, commander of the last Hubble Space Telescope servicing mission. NASA also invited the public to learn about our global environment by adopting a small part of Earth, complete with an adoption certificate to print and share on social media. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.